Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you serial adder for multiple bits addition. And the serial adder that is also referred as ripple carry adder. My dear students, you'll be observing this serial adder that is referred as serial adder because of addition is happening serially. It is not happening simultaneously. See, there are two types of adder basically when we talk about adders in computer. One is parallel adder, in which all the adders which are there inside circuit, that is giving you output at a instant. But in serial adder, output is getting transferred serially, right? Like you are having full adder circuits. So one full adder is giving output to second full adder, that second full adder that is giving output to third full adder. That is how serial data transfer is happening. So that serial data transfer, that is always slow, right? So here what I'll do is I'll explain you the basic process of making circuit for serial adder, as well as I'll explain you how exactly that is serial adder and why it is also referred as ripple carry adder. So for that, what I'll be doing is I'll be explaining you one practical example in which I'll be doing addition of 4 bits. So to understand addition of 4 bits, what I'll do is I'll be considering data A and B, which is having size of 4 bits. So A, that is having bits as per A0, A1, A2 and A3, and B is having 4 bits as per B0, B1, B2 and B3. Now let us perform this addition. So as if you want to do addition, first what you need to do, you'll have to add these two bits A0 and B0. Let us say output is sum as 0 and this is generating carry C0 that will be given over here. And now next time you have to perform addition of A1, B1 and C0. So addition of this, that is resulting into sum S1, and here there will be carry that you need to provide over here. Let us say that is C1 over here. Now you have to add these 3 bits C1, B2 and A2. So that is resulting into sum S2. And carry is provided over here. Now here you will be observing this addition is resulting into some S3 and final carry out, that is C out over here, right? So that is how 4 bits addition that we perform. Here if you observe one thing very carefully, first what we are doing, we are adding A0 B0, that is generating carry which we add over here along with A1 B1, that is generating carry which we added along with A2, B2. That is generating carry which we added with this A3, B3. And that is how we will be having final carry. So here one thing that should be clear to you, that is what that is addition is happening in serial manner, right? See, this S1 cannot be generated without C0. So first you have to add this. When you add A0, B0, it will be generating carry. After having a carry, you can have this S1 and this S2 cannot be there till you don't have carry C1. So first you'll have to add this, that will be generating C0 carry. Then you'll have to add this, it will be generating C1 carry. Now, once you have C1 carry, you can have S2, but S3 cannot be there till you don't have carry C2. So serially we are adding data, right? So here what we can say here this addition is happening in this direction serially. Now my dear students, here I'll explain you how we can form circuit. So to understand that, this basic process only that you need to understand. Like you see, first what we are doing, we are adding A0, B0. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be considering 4 full adder. Let me mention over here, all these blocks are a blocks of full adder. So here, my dear students, see with this first full adder, my inputs are A0 and B0, right? So here I'll be giving A0 and B0 as my input. But with full adder, you should know, my dear students, there are 3 inputs, right? So if you observe in my previous video also, I have explained with full adder, inputs are A, B and C, right? So third input here with this full adder, that is a carry, but that carry, let us say that is 0, C dash, that is 0 initially. So what I'll be doing is I'll be connecting that carry to ground. Ground means C dash is equals to 0, and that will be giving you output, that is sum. So sum is S0 over here, and it is generating one carry, that is C0, that will be giving it to next full adder circuit, right? So this C0 that I need to give it to next full adder circuit. Now here, if you observe with this full adder, we are adding what? A1, B1 and C0. So C0 that is generated over here, so that is given to this full adder, and another two inputs are A1 and B1. Right, it will be generating sum S1, carry C1, right? Now with next full adder, inputs are A2, B2, and this C1 which is generated by this, that is already given here. So A2 and B2, these are my inputs of this full adder. Sum will be S2 here. This will be generating carry, which will be given to next full adder, C2. And here input to this full adder, that is A3, B3, right? So A3 and B3, these are my inputs to this full adder, and sum, that is S3 over here, and final carry, that is C out over here, right? So that is how complete circuit is there. So as I have told you, this is referred as serial adder. Why? The reason is this output S1 that will happen only if you have this C0. This output S2 that will happen only if you have this C1. This output S3 that will happen only if you have C2. So this carry is getting generated serially, and that is also referred as ripple carry adder. Why? The reason is carry of one full adder is getting rippled with next full adder. Carry of this full adder that is getting rippled to the input of this full adder. Carry of this full adder that is getting rippled to input of this full adder. That's why it is referred as ripple carry adder, right? And my dear students, you should know some basics of this ripple carry adder. In next coming videos, I'll be explaining you how exactly we can have parallel adder. But some basics that you should know. Like here, carry is getting rippled to next stage of addition. That's why it is referred as ripple carry adder. Here, addition is forwarded serially. So it is referred as serial carry adder. It takes n number of machine cycles to add n bits, right? That's why it is slower. So my dear students, initially, I have already told you, this process is slow. Why? The reason is, serially addition is happening. Here we have discussed only 4 bits, but just think about the case in which you need to have addition of 50 bits. So what will happen? It will be taking 50 machine cycles. Machine cycles means what? Here, my dear students, you will have to perform addition as per machine cycle. Like first full adder is performing addition, then after only next full adder will gives you correct output, then after next full adder will gives you correct output. So every full adder requires machine cycle here in serial adder. So here that resultant addition process, that will be slow, right? So to have faster operation of addition, you should be having parallel addition. You cannot go for serial addition. So in next video, I'll explain you parallel adder, that is also referred as carry look ahead adder, which is very fast compared to this serial adder. But you should know the basic process. That's why I have explained this serial adder over here. I hope it is clear to you still. If anything that you would like to share it with me, please note down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.